Well, it's the amazing sight in the sky everybody is still talking about. The Northern Lights, they were spotted as far south as right here in central Florida. Our tower cam pointed at New Smyrna Beach last night, caught those reds and blue hues overnight. Now, the big question is, will they return tonight? Joining me tonight is Sean Dahl, Space Weather Prediction Center out there in Boulder, Colorado. Give us the answer to that million-dollar question, sir.
Yeah, it's a mystery, right? But yeah, we're on it here. We're forecasting these events. We did extend the type of activity that happened last night, what we call a G4 or a severe geomagnetic storm watch, into tomorrow, so into the 13th. We have seen that third and final CME arrive a short bit ago, and we know the potential's there for that possibility, but we'll have to wait and see what unfolds this evening to see if things become favorable and the aurora kicks in like it did last night.
So when would be the best time to view this? You know, historically speaking, you see 10 to 2 o'clock in the morning, but this is a pretty strong storm. Does it arrive earlier?
It hasn't arrived earlier. It's pretty much been on target with our forecast. The difference is, you know, I mean, it's almost winter, so we're having very long nighttime hours. So people were getting out last night. It didn't take long to turn dark. And, you know, they're still up at 7 o'clock to 11 o'clock in the evening. And the aurora was really kicking into high gear because we were reaching those severe storm levels last night. And that'll be similar again tonight. If the magnetic field in the CME, and they have magnetic energy, so you have to think of magnets, whether they repel or they attract. And that's what we're kind of waiting to see. Is it going to connect here with Earth, or is it going to repel? We're still not sure.
It's great points right there. Hey, real quick, so let's talk about how we're able to see them. What causes the Northern Lights?
It's these things called things like a coronal mass ejection, these blasts of solar material that can change charged particles and strong magnetic fields. And when they arrive here at Earth, that energy drives in through our magnetic field, and it interacts with molecules in our outer atmosphere, and that exchange of energy can release light eventually, and that's what we see as the aurora.
Now, we've had unbelievable displays, whether you're out there in Boulder, you're up in Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, or even right here on the beach in central Florida, but it's not all pretty. I mean, you have to worry about the dangers that are out there. I remember the Quebec scenario where the power grids out there took a major hit with a powerful storm. Let's talk about some of those concerns that we don't, you know, talk about. We're more into the colors and stuff, but speak to that for me for a second, would you?
Yeah, sure. Thanks for bringing that up, because that's what we do here. All day yesterday, all last night, so far today, we've been constantly communicating with all these technological critical infrastructures you're bringing up, satellite operators struggling through this storm to maintain their proper orbits, because these can burn up in the atmosphere if they don't do that with these kind of levels. The power grid operators, the bulk transmission systems, we've been talking to them extensively so that they understand what's going on, because these drive currents of energy and electricity on them that don't belong there, and they can damage the high voltage transformers that we all rely upon. So we've been communicating with them. FEMA, the response branches of the government, state watch centers, aviation, all these types of folks are who we're busy talking to when it comes to space weather, because that's the effects that we worry about, and that's the effects that we want them to be able to successfully manage. And so far, things have been working out great, with the exception of a space launch that was supposed to happen today. That got scrubbed because of the information we provide on this space weather event.
Well, because of you, it's safety comes first, and we do appreciate your hard work. Sean, I hope you get to enjoy the show tonight. I hope we get to enjoy the show, but I hope there's no concerns upstairs out there in space with all the GPS satellites out there, my friend. Thank you. Good to talk to you.
You're welcome. Take care. Thank you.